It's a Top Dad Trade Day, and we have a couple of wild turkeys with us right now. We do love you guys. Let's bring in Phil Flynn, a Fox Business Network contributor, and Alan Nuckman, the chief market strategist at BullseyeOption.com. Here we go, guys. Round number one, it factor. Of all the fundamental and technical drivers of the market, what matters the most?
Really, the only thing that really matters are earnings. I mean, for us, it's about how the price moves. That's reaction. That's what we're looking for. But the only component that drives the price, in my opinion, that you can really count on are the earnings. And if earnings are better than expected, you know, that's what boosts this market. They say that in 2022, if they come out 10% better than expected, in this last quarter they did very well, that rates really don't matter. So that's what drives the stock market, is the forward earnings.
In real estate, it's location, location, location. And stocks, it's earnings, earnings, and more earnings. And yeah, Alan is absolutely right. At the end of the day, there's a lot of forces that can drive stocks either up or down, but earnings are the final determining factor whether these things have value. Of course, stocks a lot of times can, you know, have losses and still go up, you know, if somebody believes in the company in the big term. You know, and I think the other thing we have right now is something called supply and demand. You know, the shares of stocks are a lot smaller than they were 10 or 20 years ago. And there's more people that want to participate in the stock market. So when you have less shares available, more people buying them, they have a tendency to go up. And I think that's part of what we're seeing.
Round number two, running numbers with stocks on the run. Which reaches the finish line first? Will it be S&P 5,000 or Dow 40,000?
And here they come spinning out of the return. The S&P is leading, taking a small lead right now. Now, wait a second, here comes the NASDAQ. NASDAQ coming up the back turn. Now it's the old Dow Jones average, right? I think it's going to be the S&P. I think the S&P is going to beat the Dow. The Dow's a little bit slower in its old age. I think the S&P is more reflective of the hot stocks. So I say it's going to be the S&P.
Well, that was a good call on the bratwurst in Milwaukee, where the sausage, the brat versus the Polish versus the hot dog. The S&P is about 6% away, and the Dow is about 10%. So it's got some room to go. I like the NASDAQ getting to 20,000. Big number, because that's 20% higher. And that's not that far if you look at the returns that we've seen over and over again in these tech stocks.
Round number three, stock worth. A stock is worth whatever someone is willing to pay for it. So do voting rights or dividends really matter anymore?
Well, speaking of Wisconsin, the news came out that the Green Bay Packers are going to do more shares of stock, but worthless stock. There's no voting rights. There's no dividends. They're pieces of paper you get to hang on your wall, but they're going to get hundreds, I think about $100 million from this raise to help their stadium and their cash flows and so forth. But it's interesting because a lot of people buy stock with no intention of voting and no intention of getting the dividends. They're just looking for the appreciation. So there's always opportunity. And, you know, a stock is only worth what someone's willing to pay. So just because you think something's at a high level doesn't mean it can't go a lot higher. And to get back to the earnings, I looked at some price-to-earnings ratios forward-looking and some stocks that have some real low P/E values, Allstate Insurance. I know Phil has mentioned insurance in the past. That's again a P/E of about 10. And CVS is 11. Hewlett-Packard is about 11 as well. So some of those stocks are cheap in that metric.
It's kind of interesting. You mentioned CVS. They're closing a lot of stores right now. And yeah, listen, hey, it depends on how you're playing the stock market. A lot of people don't look at earnings. I mean, don't look at dividends. They don't look at voting rights. They don't care. They just want the stock to go up. And most people give up their voting rights to whoever sends them a package in the mail. But at the end of the day, for some people, that does matter. I mean, you can look at dividends and it can make a stock a little bit more attractive, especially when you go into an area of uncertainty. So I don't think you should discount those things. But at the same time, you know, a stock, you know, right now the stock market's so hot, it probably doesn't matter as much as it once did.
It's a true or false for your bonus round question for today. Reese's created a Thanksgiving pie, weighed more than 3 pounds, and it's sold out. True or false?
True.
It's absolutely true.
The answer is true. All 3,000 pies sold almost immediately. Great job, guys. Happy Thanksgiving to you. We are very thankful for you. Thanks for making us smile. Business First AM continues.